We will show you basic operations with the Star E evaluation software. Most of the operations can be done with the free version, which you can download from www.mt.com/ta-software. Following topics will be covered: how to open curves, simple evaluations like determination of characteristic temperatures, enthalpy determination, glass transition evaluation, evaluation of steps, how to adjust the layout of evaluations, saving and export of evaluations. The Star E software evaluation window can be accessed through the main menu bar, Session tab. Pressing Evaluation window opens it up. The icon Open Curve opens up a new window, which lists the saved curves on the left side. Curves and evaluations of the Star E software are stored in a database. The database has the advantage that you cannot lose data, that original measurements are always preserved, and it allows you to easily organize your data. You can determine the data displayed by using the Open Curve Settings button on the bottom and the Filter button on the right. We will start with the DSC curve of PET. In the filter window, we type in star, followed by PET in capitals, and star. The search is case sensitive. After pressing OK, a list of the available PET curves is displayed. We highlight the appropriate one and go to the bottom coordinate system. Under the DSC tab, we choose original in the part normalization and reference temperature in the field X-axis. Press OK. Press Open. A curve is displayed which shows three characteristic effects: a step, the glass transition, followed by a peak showing upwards, the cold crystallization, and finally a peak in downward direction, the melting. Let's start with the evaluation of the step. For this, we are drawing a frame by holding down the left mouse button after we have positioned the cursor in the left top corner of the frame we intend to draw. Keep holding the button down. We drag the frame to its right bottom corner. The frame should envelop a flat portion of the baseline before the step and the same after the step. After you have drawn the frame, go to the menu point DSC Glass Transition. The glass transition evaluation is displayed as a result block with onset temperature and midpoint temperature. On the curve, three tangents are shown with two flags at beginning and end, and a plus as sign for the midpoint. In order to control the evaluation, you can zoom in by drawing a frame again and pressing the menu item Zoom. The tangents should be parallel to the flat portions of the curve and can be adjusted by grabbing them by clicking on them, holding the left mouse button down, and moving the mouse up or down. Often there is a wish to display the delta CP step height of the glass transition. You can display additional results by selecting the result block, holding the right mouse button down, and choosing the list item, optional results, and choosing delta. Delta CP in joule per gram and Kelvin is now additionally displayed. Pressing autoscale displays the whole curve again. We will now evaluate the crystallization peak. For this, we draw a frame around the upward peak and go to TA integration. The integration limits are defined by the left and right border of the frame. A baseline with flags is drawn, and a result block with the integral is displayed. Selecting the result block, right-click, and choosing optional results gives us the opportunity to select normalized value, peak, onset, baseline, and hatching. The result block then displays the normalized value, which is the enthalpy of crystallization, the onset temperature, the peak temperature, and the baseline type, which is line in this case. The integrated area is marked by hatching. Each baseline has two types of flags, one at the bottom and one on the top of the line. The bottom flag defines the length of the baseline, and the top one defines the area of integration. For effects where the baseline continues not on the same level after the effect as before the peak, one may choose another type of baseline. This is done by selecting the result block, going to Settings, Baselines, and choosing another type from the list. For example, Integral, Tangential. The change in baseline becomes effective immediately. For the melting peak, we will evaluate the onset only. For this, we are drawing a frame again. Click on the curve and go to TA Onset. The onset temperature is displayed in a result block. On the curve, the onset is the intersection point of the two tangents drawn. You can adjust the tangents by grabbing and shifting them as shown in the glass transition part. Each operation can be made undone by clicking the undo icon. Evaluations can be erased by selecting the result blocks and click on cut icon. How are annotations added? Simply click into the evaluation window where you want to place the annotation and start writing. If you want to change the position of the annotation, grab and drag it to the desired position. The annotation is attached to the last curve selected. We will finish this section with step evaluations. For this, we open up a TGA curve of calcium oxalate hydrate. A curve is displayed which shows three weight loss steps. We will evaluate the last step. In order to determine the limits of our step evaluation better, we first calculate the first derivative of our TGA curve, the so-called DTG curve. For this, we click on the curve and go to Math First Derivative. Leave the smooth settings default and click OK. A second curve showing three peaks is superimposed to our original TGA curve. We can arrange our coordinate systems by clicking on the TGA curve and using the icon Arrange Chords. The DTG curve is displayed below the TGA curve. For the step evaluation, we draw a frame enveloping the flat portion of the DTG curve before and after the last peak. Click the TGA curve and go to TA Step Horizontal. The result block of the step evaluation lists the absolute weight loss in milligram and the relative weight loss in percentage. Tangents with flags mark the step on the curve. One may be interested in the present residue after the step. Click on the result block, right-click, Optional Results, choose Residue. The following chapter shows how to nicely lay out an evaluation. In order to get rid of brackets, click on the curve and go to Edit Brackets and Triggers, and deactivate on the Show on Curve field the Brackets box. If you want to present your result in a publication or on a poster, the content should be very well visible and curves should be well to distinguish. The appearance of a curve you change by clicking on it. Right-click and choose Color, Line Style, or Font. Well visible are texts in Arial, in a font size of 14. A line width of 2 makes curves better visible. Do the same to the axis. The primary curve should be black, the second red, the third blue, and so on. And you are ready to save the evaluation. If after editing the layout some content is outside the evaluation window, then draw a frame which is sufficiently small to include the content. Click the curve and press the icon Chord Position. Click the TGA curve and click Arrange Chord in order to align the DTG curve. Save the evaluation by pressing the icon Save. An entry box appears where you enter the name of the evaluation, which appears as database entry and header of the evaluation if you plot it. It can contain up to 80 characters, but is not recommended to use more than 40. Evaluations can be exported. Two popular ways to do it are the original *E export, so that other users with the *E software can open the data and do their own evaluations, and the TIFF file export for placing evaluations in publications, posters, etc. Original star E export is done by going to File, Import, Export, Export Evaluation. In the window that opens, you highlight the name of the evaluation you want to export and define the folder in which you want to export. If you press Export, two files are exported, a file named List and a file named Zero. The List file always has to be included if you send the file Zero to another user. Otherwise, it cannot be opened by Star E software. A trick to make the evaluation content better visible is to scale the evaluation window to 800 by 600 pixels before you export the TIFF. For the TIFF file export, you go to File, Import, Export, Export Other Format. In the window that opens, you define the path of import, the name of the TIFF file, and TIFF as data type. Press Save. A new window opens, which allows you to define the bitmap width. 3,000 pixels means optimal quality, but biggest file size.